Good morning, Flagler Beach. Thank you for joining me. I hope you've had a good week, and I know you're looking forward to the weekend. I want to tell you a little story this morning about the prophet Elijah. Elijah lived in Israel in a time that it was very difficult to be a prophet. A lot of the people in Israel had fallen away and worshiping false gods, in particular the god Baal. Elijah set up a challenge between himself and the prophets of Baal that they would both build altars and just see which one their god would light up with fire. But in the meantime, he called all of the people together. Reading from 1 Kings chapter 18, and Elijah came near to all the people and said, "How long will you hesitate between two opinions? If the Lord is God, follow him, but if Baal, follow him." But the people did not answer him a word. Then Elijah said to the people, "I alone am left a prophet of the Lord, but Baal's prophets are 450 men." You know, if you'd taken a vote that day as to which God was the right God to follow, it looks like Elijah would have gotten voted out at least 450-1. He called out to the people, "Which one would you choose?" And none of them would say anything. You know, there are times when it's easy to do what's right, and then there are times when it's very difficult. I think the most difficult time to do what's right is when you're the only one doing it. But you see this time and time again with Scripture, whether it be Elijah, whether it be Daniel in the lion's den, you know, whether it be Paul in Athens on Mars Hill, whether it be any one of the different occurrences all throughout Scripture, God's people are called to do what's right, even if they're the only ones that are doing it. Because, you know, when you're the only one, that's when the real person is revealed. When everyone else around you is doing something that you know is wrong, you have a choice to make. And the choice that you make will reveal the real you. Let's focus on doing what's right, even if we're the only ones doing it. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, Lord, we just thank you for this week, Father. As we go into the weekend, Father, help us to focus on simply doing what is right, regardless as to what everyone else around us is doing, Father. Help us to focus on being right with you. Father, we love you. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thank you for joining me. And again, I hope you have a blessed weekend. Hey, I hope you enjoyed the devotional this morning. If you think somebody else might get a blessing out of it, feel free to share. If you're watching on YouTube, please subscribe. But at any rate, I hope you have a good day.